round of applause, everyone.
Okay, I want to thank you for having me. I want to thank Tyrone Brooks for telling me about this event. I want to thank Reverend Hoke Smith for hosting me on a visit to his church a couple of Sundays ago. I'm here, in a sense, because of the triumphs of the NAACP and the civil rights movement, which gave back to African Americans the right to vote that was supposedly given through the 13th, 14th, and 15th Amendments at the end of the Civil War, and then a century of white terror took away. The reacquisition of the right to vote gives you the power to determine who will be the next Democratic candidate for Congress. And for once in a blue moon, you actually have a choice. Not only is there someone running, but there are three candidates. And I'm here because of the unfinished business of the civil rights movement. And I think Martin Luther King put it very succinctly when he said, "Our nation promises to give everyone life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. But if you don't have a job and income, you have neither life nor liberty nor the possibility of pursuing happiness." Now, in the very last year of Martin Luther King's life, he decided to address the unfinished business of the civil rights movement and was about to launch a poor people's campaign. And a centerpiece of it was the demand for a job guarantee where the government would step in and offer anyone who wants work to have work serving our community. That call fell on deaf ears, despite the fact that Coretta Scott King, 6 years after Martin Luther King's death, set up a national committee for full employment to fight for the true right to work. Well, I want to renew that fight and bring it to Washington. I want there to be a federal job guarantee where our government will offer work to anyone who can't find it in the workplace at a fair wage. This is what will shut down the school-to-prison pipeline. This is what can put a brake on our mass incarceration. This is what can end the shameless situation where veterans, many of whom are African American, are begging because they're homeless on the streets. We need to end unemployment, and we can do it. It's a political decision. Are we going to show true brotherly love? Or are we going to allow greed and callousness to rule our body politic? Now, we need to fight not just for guaranteed jobs, but for a fair new minimum wage of at least $20 an hour tied to productivity increases. We need more than a living wage. We need a wage that allows us to share in the prosperity of the nation. So we need to wipe out joblessness. We need to wipe out working poverty. And when every parent can support themselves and their family with one job, we can fix our schools. We can have kids come back home. Their parents are there. They can prepare proper food. They can help them with homework. And then we can try to make ourselves equal before the law, because we are not equal before the law. We need to end cash bail, which keeps poor people rotting in jail because they don't have the money to buy their way out. We need to ensure that we all have legal representation, no matter how much money we have, not just in criminal cases, but in the civil cases we need in order to fight against police brutality, to fight against racial discrimination, to fight against sexual harassment. We need to have a legal care system for all, just like a healthcare system for all, with no copays and no deductibles, so everyone can be healthy. Everyone can have a roof over their heads, and we can fix everything in our society so we have true equal opportunity and end once and for all the intergenerational racial disadvantage that is the greatest stain on our nation. And we are not going to be a great nation until we remove that. Being the nation with the most powerful army, with the greatest wealth, that is not the road to greatness. Greatness depends upon being the most just nation in the world. And we have everything we need to do it, except the political will to do so. Well, I hope you will think about this election in this year of 2018. It is a crucial election. on which the very fate of our nation depends. Let me remind you again, you have the power to determine who will represent you in Congress. You will determine who will be the Democratic candidate. And there is a road to victory. I've been campaigning in lower income white neighborhoods in Monroe, in neighborhoods where the white working class has embraced Donald Trump and the Republican Party. But when they heard about my campaign for guaranteed jobs at fair wages, they were willing to sign on and commit themselves to vote for me. There is a path for victory if we stress the economic rights we have been ignoring. We have been ignoring as a nation, and the Democratic Party hasn't been ignoring. Now is the time for that to change. So go to the polls on May 22nd. Together we can make history. We can make the 10th District a true pioneer in our ongoing struggle for freedom. Thank you.